In this video, we're focusing on embroidery machine basics, and I wanted to answer a frequently asked question. How do you actually download embroidery design files and get them to your embroidery machine? Welcome to the Sewing Report, I'm Jen and this channel is all about making sewing and crafts fun and approachable. There are lots of places to buy embroidery designs online, but the process I'll be showing you is fairly universal across different websites. This tutorial is being demonstrated on a Windows-based computer, so it is not for Mac users. I found a few designs and a font from this Etsy shop, so let's buy these. Check out and pay for the order. On most websites, you get a message or an email after checkout directing you to download the files. Now, I have two separate folders for these. One is for the initial downloads because the files are compressed or zipped, and you'll need to unzip them later. The other is for the uncompressed embroidery files. Alright, we've made it to the Etsy downloads page, and here are all the zipped files I need to download individually, and I save them to my embroidery downloads folder. Yes, this is somewhat tedious. To find the most recent downloads, I sort the folder by date modified, and the newest ones show up right at the top. Right-click with your mouse and select Extract All from the menu. The extracted or unzipped files are saved to the same folder. Do this for each zipped file folder. There will be a lot of files, but they actually don't take up a lot of hard drive space. What I'm doing now is decompressing all the files so they can actually be used. When these are all done, I then move them over to the second folder. You can select multiple files at a time by clicking on a file, holding down the Shift key, then selecting the last file. Most embroidery downloads will include the actual design files in various formats compatible with different machine brands, but they also usually come with image preview files and instructions. It can be a bit intimidating due to the sheer number of files included because it's a bunch of different sizes in every single format. The way you can tell is that each file name ends with a period, then a three-character designation. The embroidery machine I use is the Brother PE800, and it takes .pes files. What I'll be doing is taking an external USB flash drive, inserting it into my computer, putting the files on it, taking it out, and then inserting it into the embroidery machine. So take the USB flash drive and insert it into one of your slots on the computer. A window pops up for the drive K here, and you can see all the files on it. To transfer files onto it, click and drag the files on the computer into the window for the USB flash drive. With Windows-based operating systems, it is important to safely remove hardware before ejecting. Abruptly removing USB devices can cause it to become corrupted or experience data loss. Down at the bottom right, there's a little arrow. Click it and a menu pops up. Click on the little white rectangle that represents a USB device. Then you can select which device you want to eject. Now you can safely remove the USB drive from the computer and plug it into the slot on the embroidery machine. To access these files on the Brother PE800, select the button in the lower right-hand corner that kind of resembles a squid. Use the left and right arrows to navigate the files on the USB drive. I've been using the Embrilliance embroidery software, and there are a number of different price tiers ranging from free to more advanced. There is an affiliate link below if you want to check this out. The free version is Embrilliance Express, and you can import BX embroidery fonts to be able to type these out and save as embroidery files. I've got a new project file open, and here is the BX version of the font I purchased. To import these into the program, you just have to drag and drop onto a project page. This font does include several sizes. Using software and BX fonts is great for words and phrases, eliminating the need to import each individual character directly into the machine. I have the paid Essentials tier, and I can mix and match designs and fonts then save them into a new file. I'm so excited to try this flamingo design because it has this 3D looking fringe. I know not everyone is super tech savvy, so that's why I wanted to create this beginner walkthrough for downloading embroidery designs. I've done previous videos about embroidery software and the Brother PE800 that will be linked in the description box. Thanks for watching. I'm Jen with the Sewing Report, and remember, whatever you're doing, make it fun.